40 years now, Luciano Pavarotti has been the greatest ambassador opera has ever had. He grew up in the Italian tradition of Caruso, Gigli, and Di Stefano, and history may judge that he was the greatest of them all. His musical brilliance and huge personality have allowed him to dazzle popes, pop stars, and politicians, and have given him audiences that Enrico Caruso could never have dreamed of. Over the course of a year, we built up an intimate record of Pavarotti's personal and performing life. We attended the christening of his baby daughter, next to his wedding to Nicoletta Mantovani. We climbed on board Pavarotti's traveling circus as the three tenors reunited and as he sang in concert halls and stadiums across three continents, before waving an emotional farewell to the Metropolitan Opera in New York. Our year with Luciano began with a concert in California, where a relaxed maestro schmoozed the sold-out crowd with Neapolitan songs and favorite arias.
I'm bringing it this time.
Talk about what?
Thank you very much. Give me the telephone number of the house.
Thank you very much.
Ciao.
I'll see you in May.
When I tell Nicoletta, she will be thrilled.
And give her my blessings.
Thank you very much.
Please, all right, my
thank
friend.
You.
Take care.
Ciao, ciao.
All right now.
Thank you.
Get some water, guys. All right.
Take care. Have some water.
Nice to see you.
Sure. Thank you very much.
Pavarotti entrusts his professional affairs to Terry Robson. He has worked closely with her since 1988.
Since the retirement was announced, Pavarotti's office has been flooded with invitations to appear all over the world. But he actually accepts a very low percentage of the offers that are made to him. It's Pavarotti himself who decides ultimately where and when he sings. He always has. All Pavarotti's decisions have been his own, and it's his own ambitions and instincts which have driven his career.
The tenor is preparing to release a new album, Ti Adoro. He has scheduled a photo session with the prestigious Italian fashion photographer, Fabrizio Ferri. Ferri has also been entrusted with the sensitive task of taking the first official portraits of Luciano, Nicoletta, and their new baby, Alice. Nicoletta suffered a difficult pregnancy, and Alice's twin brother, Riccardo, died during childbirth in January. Intrusive press coverage has left her with a deep distrust of the media. Pavarotti has a shrewd sense of his place in opera's great tradition and doesn't mind using new technology to tell the world about it. He draws his strength from Italy's lineage of famous singers.
Oh.
Ecco, ecco. Ecco, ancora una volta.
La pace torna nel suolo a me,
ce l'ha cavata?
Male,
no, 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 ce l'ha cavata tanto dalle coppe.
Che bestia.
Cioè, per noi la, il divo dell'inarrivabile era Caruso, cioè il Caruso poi che ci passava la tecnologia di allora, dei dischi tutti stonati, si capiva appena appena, però la voce pastosa, si sentiva la voce pastosa. E in quel periodo allora c'erano tanti tenori, Tagliavini, Gigli, eccetera, ma pensare che un giorno si sarebbe posto a livello di Caruso.
I remember this movie very well. I remember all, I mean, it can be any of them, because I saw all. The voice is so Italian, so warm.
The Philadelphia-born Nanza hadn't been anywhere near La Scala, but for Pavarotti, he was proof that a tenor could be both pop idol and opera star.
You see, it is an old-fashioned movie, but true. This is another big truth. Because it's going on even now, you see. Very well done. Old-fashioned, very well done. And after that, I went home. And in front of the mirror, I try the same song. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. My idol is Di Stefano. I remember the I fight with my father because we were hearing on the radio all the voices of the tenor of that period. And Beniamino Gigli was at the very, very head of this. And one day, my father was not at home. I hear this young voice. And I hear that the name is not Beniamino Gigli. It's called Di Stefano. So my father come home and they say, Papa, I hear somebody that I like more than Gigi. I think my father was the only time he slapped me in the face. Going to approach the house where I was born. Now here is old houses, but when I was born was old ground, and we did grow up like little wild animal. It was incredible.
Queste parole d'amore che ti sospiro forse non s'usano più. Mamma, ma la canzone mia più bella sei tu, sei tu.
I always, when I was a kid, I always jump from up from the window touching these two things here. And all here, where you see all the houses, was ground.
The Pavarottis weren't wealthy, and both parents worked hard to feed their family. Adele worked in a tobacco factory, and Fernando had a job in a bakery across town.
My father was a baker. When the school is over, I always go to help him rolling the bread. I enjoy immensely because you see a product that is the basic product from the humanity around the world, I think. And making from flour is a kind of creation that makes me satisfied.
Pavarotti is reluctant to tear himself away from the fine food and Ferraris of his hometown, so he uses his global prestige to bring the world to his doorstep instead. Every spring, he transforms quiet provincial Modena into an Italian Hollywood. The Pavarotti and Friends concert has become an annual fixture since it was first staged in 1992. Pavarotti's objective is to lure international celebrities to the event and to make as big a publicity splash as possible, then use the proceeds to help child victims of war. He has never forgotten how it felt to be a child growing up in the clash of opposing armies during World War II.
Pavarotti and Friends is very hard work for Luciano. He's often singing outside his normal repertoire and so needs to make many adjustments to learning and singing styles. He takes about a month ahead of the show to prepare.
For this year's Pavarotti and Friends, he has assembled another lineup of stars who could pave Modena with platinum discs. They will raise funds for refugee children from Iraq. Pavarotti has been ridiculed for debasing his art by singing with pop stars, but he's always believed that the tenor is a popular singer, not just a precious specimen who can only blossom in the rarefied climate of the opera house.
I first met the maestro on the phone, and he was harassing me. He would ring our housekeeper, and he would say, "It's Luciano Pavarotti here. Tell God to give me a call." You know, it's like they were laughing in the house. He's rang again. You have to write him this tune. And of course, I was hugely, hugely flattered. But wasn't able to. Then the final phone call comes and he says, it's Easter coming. And I said, yes. I said, I'm taking a little break with my kids. He said, I know that God is going to put a song in your heart for me. And I just started laughing because this is one of the great emotional arm wrestlers of the age. And so with my hand behind me back, I went off on holidays and woke up with the song that became Miss Sarajevo.
Surreal in her crown.
I know what is war. I know what is to be bombed. War is when they bomb your city, not when you bomb the city of the other.
The war in Italy was bitter and bloody. And every year in Modena, a wreath is laid at the partisans' memorial in the town square. One night, the shadow of the swastika fell across the Pavarotti family.
The German one night arrested my father and my grandfather. My father, being a baker, he was going up and down every day with the bicycle from the city where he was baking the bread to the country where we were sleeping. And my grandfather, he was working in the military academy, serving at the table. So they were arrested because the partisan did kill 5 Deutsch people. And for 5 of them, 50 Italian will be hanged. So you can imagine my father and my grandfather, the feeling that they have. And finally, they learned who they were and they let them free. But they hang some of them. Terrible. Bad, bad memory. I remember just one day of the war. I was very, very, very happy, enthusiastic. It was the day of the liberation. And in that precise moment, you say to yourself, now I am going to live. I am going to live without looking for what is right or wrong in the world. Is the world, if you are alive, is plenty enough.
Costanza, tiranna del cuore, chiama qual morbo crudele. Sol chi vuole, si servi fedele, non va a morno, no, se non v'è libertà. De mariti il famoso furore, de diamanti le spalle. Di cento occhi di sfido, sempre fugge, una qualche beltà. Se mi fugge, una qualche beltà.
Although his physique has become less than athletic, Pavarotti was a skillful teenage footballer. and he and his friends have been Juventus supporters since boyhood.
Nessun dorma, nessun dorma. Tu pure, o principessa, nella tua fredda stanza.
In the 2003 Champions League final, Juventus confront their arch-rivals, AC Milan. Pavarotti and his veteran teammates gather around his television in Modena, hoping to conjure up an epic victory for the men of Juve. The match has to be decided on penalties. Juventus pray that their ace goalkeeper Buffon can save Andrei Shevchenko's crucial kick.
All'inizio mio fratello non era così forte. Quindi allora si diceva che effettivamente il papà avesse questa grandissima voce, ma erano più che altro scaramucce tra di loro. Timido, era molto riservato, aveva avuto l'occasione di fare un provino alla Scala, ma non si sentì di andare. Lui dedusse che non voleva lasciare la famiglia, ma noi sappiamo che era per la paura, per palcoscenico.
Perché lui ha sempre messo una tenacia nel... Sì, lui lavorava e cantava, cioè andava a scuola. Cioè quando si diplomò lui si mise a fare, fece il dopo scuola un po', ma fece l'assicuratore per due o tre anni, ma andava a scuola.
Sometimes they ask me, tell me the most significant performance of your life. And they always say there is more than one, but certainly this, you see, is my debut. That is one of the greatest significant night. Because like I told you, I was an insurance seller. And that night instead I become a tenor, who is a big, big jump.
Pavarotti's victory in the 1961 Achille Peri singing competition won him the role of Rodolfo in La Bohème. It was the moment that brought the rest of his life into sharp focus. It cut him free from the doubts that had held back his father and afforded Luciano a view of a future that would stretch far beyond Modena's city walls.
We travel with a group of around 10 people. He has a tour manager, security manager, two assistants, and of course, whenever possible, he travels with Alice and Nicoletta as well. he will always take his own food around wherever he goes. He takes his food from Modena, basically.
Pavarotti's only opera performance in 2003 is in Tosca at the Deutsche Oper in Berlin. The piece has become his swan song speciality. It was the last opera he sang at Covent Garden, and this will probably be his final opera appearance in Europe. Pavarotti has lost count of the times he has sung the role of the painter Cavaradossi. But he's been around too long to believe that nothing can go wrong. Even after 40 years, the superstitious tenor always puts himself through a series of quaint little rituals before he ventures on stage.
Luciano è abbastanza superstizioso. Ha paura un po' di tutte le superstizioni italiane, no? Per esempio il gatto nero che attraversa la strada, passare sotto una scala e tante cose. Soprattutto ha paura di un'opera di Verdi che non vuole mai sentir nominare, per cui non ne faccio il nome neanche adesso, perché lui è convintissimo che gli porti disgrazia. E forse è un po' esagerato anche in questo. Prima di cantare cerca i chiodi in palcoscenico e tutti quelli che trova se li mette in tasca. Penso che non ne abbia bisogno, insomma, dati i suoi formidabili mezzi vocali, che non abbia bisogno di avere queste paure, però certamente forse lo aiutano psicologicamente a creare un clima così scaramantico.
People hear your voice and they say, that's Pavarotti. They know immediately it's you. So why do you think that is?
I don't know. Can be even the defect of the voice. You never know. The personality is coming out even in the voice. There is something that you do without asking yourself why you do it. Just following your musical instincts.
One of the main reasons Pavarotti has sung so long and kept his voice is that he's never sung roles that are not suitable for his voice. And he's always taken good advice seriously. Advice about roles, advice about how to use his voice, advice on techniques.
Ciao! Ciao, ciao!
What happened with Luciano Pavarotti and myself was a unity of purpose. He wanted success. He wanted to be extremely well known. He wanted everything that could happen to a tenor. That's what he wanted. So that we formed this partnership. He was open-minded and in a way open-hearted too. So that made him into a very unusual kind of tenor. Most tenors are dreary. Most opera singers are dreary. We started in 1967-68. He made his Met debut, and then of course he came back to the Met, and every performance that he did increased his cachet, increased the fact that people, who was this guy, this great face, this great voice, the sound of that voice was hadn't been heard for many, many years. He gave you goose pimples. He made the hair on your hands, you know, stand on edge. The music that he sang was very romantic. Luciano was a romantic hero. And so women swooned, and so did men. So did children. So did dogs. He sang Bohème. He sang Elise d'Amore. He sang Bel Canto, lyric repertory for the tenor. And he sang it better than anybody else.
What am I? Am I successful or am I famous? That I don't know. I don't care. I know that people recognize me on the street. Very good. But I have three daughters and one wife. And when I am at home, I know exactly who I am. Nothing. Exactly zero. But I am happy.
Even successful nothings carry the American Express card.
Modena is a small, intimate community inclined to consider itself superior to other Italian cities. The locals were quick to take sides when Pavarotti separated from his first wife, Adua, who he divorced in 2000. Some Modenese have always resented what they consider the airs and graces of a mere baker's boy and would love to see Pavarotti's pretensions cut down to size.
Pensa che Modena lo ama così tanto come lui ama Modena?
Io sono sincero, dico il mio parere personale. Gli amici lo adorano. Quegli altri invece c'è molta ripicca. Dicono che nessuno è profeta in patria e probabilmente Luciano è così, per il mondo esterno.
Every summer, Luciano and his family maintain an old Pavarotti tradition by heading for the ocean and his hillside house in Pesaro, the Villa Giulia. Luciano likes to relax by playing the traditional Italian card game of briscola.
La passione per il canto c'è sempre stata. Lui andava là e io ascoltavo. Ascoltavo e nell'ascoltare poi cercavo di apprendere, imparare qualche cosa per poi duellare con lui nel canto. E praticamente nel tempo ho duellato e non poco. Devo dire che anche con una certa fierezza, pur riconoscendo che lui aveva dei, era un'altra cosa, che era di livello superiore, anche perché poi così ne approfittavo delle sue arti vocali per andare a incontrare o salutare una qualche ragazza.
Luciano was always a dreamer. He's still like that now. He thought to have a voice to sing. He did have and still possess a voice of a mule. Fantastic, with incredible sound. But he fell in love twice. So he pretend that I'm going to sing for him, and he stay under the balcony acting, and inside the porch me singing. And I say, okay, let's do. We do like Cyrano. And what do you want me sing? Which love song do you want me do? He says, La Donna Mobile. Say, oh, really?
La donna è mobile, qual fiume al vento, muta d'accento e di pensiero. Sempre un amabile, leggiadro viso, impianto in riso e menzognero. La donna è mobile, qual fiume al vento, muta d'accento.
Vittoria, Vittoria,
Vittoria,
Chi ti ha fatto quelle calzette che ti stanno si bene, che ti stanno si bene, giro metta, che ti stanno si bene.
Yet?
Tell us why you like spending so much time down here.
Here in this place, I should make this question to you. Because you see that this is a paradise. It's beautiful. We are at the beach, we are in the mountain. Pesaro is a real city. So when you have kids, there is the hospital. And it's quiet. The people are very quiet here. They have their own philosophy of life. They are a little suspicious of what is the progress, the excessive progress. I think they have a great philosophy of life, and I like very much to stay here.
Famiglia, immaginava che un giorno sarebbe diventato così famoso?
No. Nemmeno per un attimo noi pensavamo che lui fosse arrivato così in alto. Perché è stata una scala continua. Una scala continua di attività che si sono susseguite. Chiamiamola dose di fortuna, io dico l'uno e l'altro. Perché nel momento in cui lui prese il posto di Stefano a Londra, credo che da lì si siano aperte le porte per lui in un modo molto grande.
Like many other things in his life, Pavarotti's luck was served in enormous portions. When the three tenors sang at Rome's Baths of Caracalla, the event might have been designed in marketing guru heaven. The trio rode the euphoria of the 1990 World Cup and gripped the world's imagination in a way that classical performers rarely do. The live recording remains classical music's all-time bestseller.
Yeah.
we were seen from 1.5 billion of people. I think Caruso sang probably for 100,000 people in all his career.
But sometimes the spotlight glared too brightly. Pavarotti became as recognizable as any Hollywood star and caught the attention of the Italian authorities. He had to repay millions of lire to the government, but was cleared of filing false tax returns by a Modena court. When he separated from his wife Adua in the 90s, his musical achievements were drowned by the catcalls from the press. The Three Tenors concert in Bath was the most unusual in their history. It was paid for by the Malaysian tycoon who owns Wessex Water, and tickets were given away free. However, the tenors themselves did not sing for nothing.
People are always responding to you in the quality of what you do. The more quality, the better. Not quantity. Quantity means nothing. Too many three tenor concerts. You know, what do you have to study for? You're going to do another three tenor concert, you're going to walk home with not, I don't know how many hundreds of thousands of dollars. You know, the more hundreds of thousands of dollars you get, the better you feel. Don't you? And he was not shy of wanting that money.
Throughout the year, Pavarotti has been struggling with conflicting emotions. Fatherhood has been an unexpected bonus, even as his retirement looms closer. The shock of losing both his parents the previous year took a heavy toll on him.
Questa è stata una martellata in testa per lui. Questa è stata una martellata in testa perché I genitori si tengono sempre volentieri. In più il papà non era solo il papà, ma era anche l'amico. Era l'amico, era il confidente.
He was one of the most honest person, charming, very charming person. Young, till the age of 89, when he died, unfortunately, leaving me alone like a dog because we were brother, we were pal. And we will talk another time.
He's not humble front of house, but backstage, he is humble. But I love the ballsy side to him, that mischievous thing that's also there, you know, who'll take on the big fight. I think he got that from his old man. We were eating in Pesaro, and at the end of the meal, Luciano's father sang beautifully, and everyone clapped. At the end, he just turned to his son and just went, "If only you had have had my voice."
think how far you would have come.
And I just thought, see where he gets it now.
Luciano and Nicoletta have arranged for the christening of Alice in Modena Cathedral, where Luciano and Fernando once sang together. The ceremony resembles a Renaissance tableau of a prominent Modenese dynasty.
Tira forte il vento su una vecchia terrazza davanti al golfo di Sorrento. Un uomo abbraccia una ragazza dopo che aveva pianto. Poi si schiarisce la voce e ricomincia il canto. Te voglio bene.
And are you looking forward to December the 13th?
Scared to death. But very scared. I know I was very scared before. But very enthusiastic. But very scared.
So they'd had a Alice earlier that year, and the 13th of January was the day she was born, so the 13th of the month is lucky for them. Very superstitious people, both of them, so 13th of December was a gap in the schedule, and that's when they decided to get married. The celebration itself wasn't a big media event. Luciano and Nicoletta wanted a celebration with family and friends. That is essentially what they got. The Catholic Church wouldn't allow the wedding to take place in the church, so the wedding ceremony itself took place in the Teatro Comunale. And Pavarotti in his speech declared that the theatre was the church of the artist.
Critics who say that a maestro doesn't sing with the same golden voice that he had some years ago. These are people who know nothing, not just about opera or about music. They don't know anything about art, because who wants gold in art, in music, is about the base metals. And it's the magic of turning them into gold. That's what's important. So in Pavarotti's voice, it's not just about gold. It's about brass. It's about iron. It's about rust. It's about wood. And it's all this range of experience that he's had over his life that actually gives us the great voice. The voice either makes you cry or it doesn't. The idea that somehow hitting a note a certain way, this is ridiculous. These people should be locked up.
Day is right. Wow.
Pavarotti's return to New York carries a weight of personal significance. It has always been a special city for the tenor, and it's here he will give his last ever opera performances. Pavarotti wants to bid a fitting farewell to the Met, but even if he were to be reborn on stage as his 30-year-old self, it would not be enough to appease some of the city's vengeful opera critics. 2 years earlier, a throat infection forced him to cancel his appearances in Tosca at short notice. New Yorkers reacted with outrage, and the Met's dignity was affronted. Pavarotti's relationship with the Met stretches back 36 years. It marks his farewell with a lavish lunch.
And when I think about being here at this luncheon today, honoring one of the greatest singers of our generation, if not of all time, I think about my grandfather, because my grandfather took a boat from Genoa, had only $20 in his pocket, and one of his great joys was being able to occasionally get standing room tickets to watch Caruso perform. And when I think of Luciano, I think of Caruso, an Italian tenor who lifted opera even above itself.
In some sense, you're a slave to your own voice.
You are. You are the slave in a very golden case. But you want that. For another person, you can use the word slave. For a singer, for me, I just say that that is my apartment.
Bocqualupo, maestro.
I wish him a long life, and I loved all this thing. Like I'm only doing Tosca one more time. Oh, fuck off. You know, he's very young. That's why he likes, I think, just to be around the new. You know, he has that. He's a childish enthusiasm for life, and he's a big baby with a beard.
After the final performance, The cheers and applause resounded for more than 11 minutes.
Luciano Pavarotti, I say to all of you, goodbye soon, arrivederci, ciao.